Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li hadha wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Ahmaduhu subhanahu wa ta'ala wa ashkuru. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna sayyidina Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Amma ba'd. يقول الله تعالى في القرآن العظيم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا صدق الله العظيم. All praises are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is He, Allah, who has guided us to Al-Islam. Had it not been for His guidance, we would have certainly been on the wrong path. We glorify Allah and we thank Him for His guidance, His protection. We thank Allah for all His bounties, His favors, and His blessings upon us. I testify that there is none to be worshipped but Allah. He is alone and He has no partner. And I testify that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is His servant and final messenger. Ibadallah. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran that He sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the Quran, a book of guidance. He sent him as a model for humanity. He sent him so that He can instruct us as to what is lawful and what is unlawful, the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. And whatever the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has enjoined upon you, that this is lawful, take it, practice it. Make sure that it is the way you conduct your life. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. And whatever He has said to you that it is unlawful, keep away from it, abstain from it. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us in the Quran that this man who came with the Quran, whatever he says, it is the truth. And so we must pattern our lives based on what was said by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah tells us in the Quran, وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. He does not say anything of his own accord, except that it is wahy, revelation, given to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we need to ensure that life is lived in accordance with what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam brought to us. Today, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, I want to remind you that life must be lived in such a way that we are always cooperating with one another in that which leads towards piety, righteousness. That we are always cooperating with one another in that which will get us more connected to our Creator, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. And always work together, cooperate with one another with that which leads towards piety, righteousness, goodness, and do not cooperate with one another in that which leads towards enmity and hatred. And so, I want for us to understand that this cooperation, it is not limited to one sector of the community. And that is very important for us to know. Because quite often we see cooperation among the elders, and there is non-respondence from the young ones. And then quite often we see cooperation among the young, and the elders do not get involved. And so today, I want to remind you and remind myself that we are indeed living in difficult times. We are indeed living in challenging times. In what we experienced decades ago, there are those who will experience worse in present day and in time to come. And so there must be that harmony. There must be that total cooperation between the young and the old, the elders and the youth. If we look back at what has been done over the years, let's look at this country, for example. Muslims came and there was nothing. The few who were here, they tried to maintain their identity. They tried their best to make sure that they were able to pray to Allah. They had to go miles and miles just to find a place where they can slaughter animals or they can have halal meat to eat. But as more and more people came, they started to build masajid and institutions, and we have so many halal businesses that even today, it's not only the Muslims who are looking into halal businesses, selling halal meat. We see non-Muslims are looking at it that this is a very lucrative business, and so we should get involved in it. And so when we look at our present situation and look at the past, yes, indeed, we have done well. There are masajids, there are institutions, there are Muslim businesses, halal businesses, and alhamdulillah, we have done well. Let us not become complacent. And let us not think that that's the end of it. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, we are living in a time where pornography has become so much accessible. There is so much racism and stereotypes. Alcohol, gambling, smoking everywhere you walk around, smoke shop. And some of these smoke shops, they're being run by Muslims. Vaping. Oh, I'm not smoking anymore. I'm not smoking cigarette, but I'm vaping now. And that's the order of the day. Social media, it has corrupted the lives of the young ones. People are faced with depression, anxiety, disorder. LGBTQ, it's on the rise. Muslim teachers have to teach it in public schools, even though they do not accept it. And children have to learn about it. These are the things, or some, that we are being confronted with today. Young parents, think about it. You know, yesterday I was speaking to a father and I said to him, Alhamdulillah, that your children have grown up and they're in colleges and you don't have to worry about what happened in the system today, in the educational system. And he said to me, yes, I still have to worry because my children, they will become mothers and fathers. And their children will become my grandchildren. I want them to maintain their identity. There's an identity crisis in this country, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. People don't know if they're males or females. And so he said, yes, I need to still worry. There must be that fikr, there must be that worry within me because of my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren. Maybe I did well by my children, but what will they do by their children? And we have so many young mothers and fathers today. Don't think that everything has been done for you and life is okay. It takes, as they say, a village to raise a child. It's really a true statement. And some people feel that, yes, I'm doing well by my children and we will be okay. And if we're not okay here, we'll go somewhere else. These issues that I mentioned, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, they're global issues. It's not only here in America. So if you think that you will run away from here to another country, another state, and you will not have to worry about, pornography, you will not have to worry about social media, you will not have to worry about gay and lesbians, think again. So it takes a village to raise a child. And so everyone needs to be involved. Whether you're young or whether you're old, we need to work together to create an environment that is an environment where Allah is being remembered all the time. An environment in which what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has given us as lawful, that we take it and we practice it. And what he has given us as unlawful, we abstain from it. That's the type of environment that we need to create. And leaders need to do more than just thinking that because we have a few programs in the masjid that we are okay. Look at it, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. We are only focusing on a very tiny percent of the Muslim population on these programs that we have. We have to think outside of the box. What else can we do? Because the majority do not come to the masjid. The majority do not come to pray. The majority are not so much connected with the institutions that we have built. What do we do? We need to think out of the box. How can we reach them? How can we have them help us to create this environment in which we will remain on that fitra on which we were born? Kullu mauludin yulad ala fitra. Every child is born with the understanding that there is only one true God. Every child is born with the inclination towards goodness. Halal and haram, that's embedded within us. But the environment is so important because it moves us away from that concept of halal and haram. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we need to work together to protect the next generation of Muslims. We need to work together as we look around. Look at how many young people are here today. What will be their future? Who will they get married to? And we see so many inter-religious marriages in our community. And sometimes people only accept Islam for the moment. I'll be a Muslim today so I can marry this girl. Or I'll be a Muslim today so I can marry this boy. And then they go back to what their practices were before marriage. Alhamdulillah for those who have maintained, they said shahada and they came into Islam and they continue to be Muslims. But look at it. Sometimes it's the Muslims who make them turn away. Because many of the boys and girls who bring people into Islam, they themselves do not practice. So how do you expect someone who you brought into the faith to really accept it as a true faith? If you are the one who was born into it and you are not practicing, you do not pray, you do not fast, you swear, you don't have any adab. And these are the realities that we are facing today, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Every one of us must have that concern. And I don't think it's only I who am seeing this. We are all seeing it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, "Man lam yahtam bi amr al-muslimin falaysa minhum." Or kama qala sallallahu alayhi wasallam, "He who does not concern himself with the affairs of the Muslims, he is not from among them." You belong to some other denomination if you do not have that concern for your brothers and your sisters. And so let's think about the future. We look at our past and we struggled to get where we are today. But Muslims always look beyond the present. Look at that man who was chasing after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Quraysh placed on his head 100 camels. And he was looking to find the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam before he migrated, so that he can bring him back to Quraysh and he will receive his ransom. Disbeliever. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him about the future. "How would you like to wear the jewels of the Persian leader?" And so as a believer, he wore the jewel of the Persian leader. Look at the insight, look at the foresight of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, planned for the future. And so my dear brothers and my dear sisters, do not become complacent that everything is okay. Everything is not okay. And don't think that you will be able to do it by yourself. Because indeed it takes a village to raise a child. And so everyone, whether you are male, you are female, whether you are young, you are old, whether you are grandfather, grandmother, or you are just a mother or father, whatever it is, remember we need to cooperate together. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it beautifully in the Quran, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْدُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْدِ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أُولَئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. The believing men and the believing women, aren't we believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes, indeed, we are believers. And that is why we are here, to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believing men and the believing women, they are helpers unto one another. They cooperate with one another. They work with each other in everything that leads towards goodness, piety, righteousness. They enjoin right and they forbid evil. They help one another in the enjoyment of right and the forbidding of evil. They help one another in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to build an environment in which the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never neglected. That people are always there worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we need to build an environment in which there is always those who will cooperate with each other in helping those who are in need. That no one should be left without his needs being met. That's the type of environment. And we need to build that environment. We need to work together to make sure that we are obedient to Allah and obedient to His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, whatever I have said today, maybe it is not the normal khutbah that you would hear, but just think about it, that we are not safe from the evils of this society. And the more and more we look at it, if we do not work together to ensure that people stay connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more and more difficult it would be for us to overcome the challenges that we are facing and that we will face in time to come in the society that we live in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. May Allah protect us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to maintain our true identity, that we are Muslim males and females who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are Muslims who strive for dunya and for akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good in this life and good in the life hereafter. And may He save us from the torment of the hellfire. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum wa li sa'iril mu'minin mu'minat min kulli dhanb fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahabihi ajma'in, ridwanullahi alayhim ila yawmiddin, amma ba'd. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, I wish to remind you and remind myself, let's take Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our role model. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Verily, in the Messenger of Allah is a perfect example for you. Look what he did. He left Mecca, he went to Medina, and he built an Islamic community, a community in which the Ansar looked out for the Muhajireen. He built a community in which people, they cared for one another. He built a community in which people were always looking as to how they can excel in their worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, as we look at challenges, let us look at making sure that we strive to acquire knowledge that would be useful to us and beneficial to us. Let us have high expectations of ourselves. Don't be lackadaisical, don't be lazy. Let us always look at making sure that our livelihood, it is always from lawful means. Because you want to ensure that what you put into your body, that it is being accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and always plan for the future. And it's not planning in terms of just, I want a better life. I'm not making enough today. I want to make more in the future. That's okay. But I'm talking about the future of your children, the future of the grandchildren, the future of this Muslim community. You know, you can make an enormous sum of money and you can have the best of jobs, but that is not what the future should look like. The future should look like this when we look at our congregation, when we look at our families and we look at our brothers and sisters and we look at everyone, that there is that joy, that happiness, that everyone brings coolness to our eyes. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما. Our Lord, grant us from our spouses and our offspring, our children, our progeny, those who will bring comfort to our eyes. And comfort doesn't come just because they're making six figure. Comfort doesn't come just because they're doctors and they're attorneys and they're engineers, but comfort comes when they are good Muslims. They have good adab, they behave well, they have patience in their lives, they're good mothers, they're good fathers, they treat their children well. That's where comfort comes. وَجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. And make us from among those who will be the leaders of the righteous. And you can't lead the righteous if you are not righteous yourself. People will follow you. Your children will follow you. Your grandchildren will follow you. Others will follow you when you lead righteous life. And so we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and protect us and save us from the calamities that we see around us. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we work together to overcome the challenges that we face in present-day society. لقد أمرنا الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن العظيم حيث قال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وأرضى اللهم عن خلفائه الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ونسيت الباقين مبشرين بالجنة ونسائر الصحابة ونتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم نور قلوبنا بنور الإيمان وثبت قلوبنا على دين الإسلام ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاشكروا الله على نعمه واذكروه على آلائه ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقم الصلاة